Hey guys, so on one of my most popular videos, I did an Ibis Paint X tutorial, and a lot of you were confused on the lasso or selection tool, and so I finally figured it out, and so in this video, I'm going to show you how to use this tool. Before I get started, please subscribe to my channel so you can get updated on new posts I do. So if we scroll up to the top, we can select the selection layer, and as you can tell right away, it's this blue color, and it's kind of faded, kind of transparent, so you can see what you're doing underneath it. And it works just like a normal, regular pen. You can change the type it is, you can erase it or add new onto it. You can do whatever you can with a regular pen. To see what the point of this is, say, for example, like in this post, I decided that my eye didn't look good enough. So I could take a regular dip pen hard, which is the common tool people usually use, and color the outside of the entire eye, outline it. So as you can see, I'm coloring the whole thing. A common mistake a lot of people use is they don't fill in the inside, they just do the very outside, and that won't work. Every part that the blue is, that's the part that you can fix. So I'm just fixing it up a little bit there, so it covers the entire eye. Now, if I go onto the layer that this eye is, the part that I want to fix, as you can see, there's a black and white striped line around the area I colored blue. So what this does, similar to Alpha Lock, is all the actions that you complete can only be completed in this lassoed area. So if I were to draw a line there, it would only be in the lassoed area, including if I were to erase anything, it would only be in the lassoed area. If I were to do anything to it, effects, anything, it would only be in the lassoed area. So an example why you might want to use this is to change what it looks like. For example, if I go to the functions or effects key, I'm not sure what it's, the FX stands for, but I can change the hue, I can change how black and white it is, and oftentimes I just kind of come here and fool around with the different tools, and honestly, I'm not sure what they even all do, because a lot of them are for really advanced people. Like, I don't know what this one does. It does not look the best, but there's so many different things you can do to change what it looks like, and it will only be in the lassoed area. The current filter I'm using is really good when you're using it with backgrounds. It's something that makes a real life picture look more like an anime background. So if you ever try to make an anime, if you just search up like a picture of buildings, you can make it look like it's in an anime. So another reason you might need to use this is if you need to change the size of something. So if we go here to this slide, you can change, you can completely move around where it is, including change how big or small it is. So if you thought it was a little bit too small, you could use this. Perspective form makes something that looks flat kind of look more three-dimensional, which is good if you're like making a book or something. You can also rotate the eye if it's like too crooked or something. And mesh form is great for like if you search up a logo and put it on a shirt that you're working on or anything like that that you need to change the size of it. As you can tell, this is not the best function for eyes because it looks very warped now, but it's easy to get rid of that just by hitting the undo button, and now it's back to normal. Now, to turn the selection mode off, all you have to do is go to the selection layer and erase the blue, and then you'll be back to normal. But really, in selection mode, it's just like making a new layer. All of these features right here that I pulled up, you can use. You can use anything on selection layer, but it will only write on the layer that you have colored. So as you can tell, this drawing is not my style. It was a line art that I colored, a collaboration on Sketch. So please check out my Sketch video, and thank you for my 1.5K followers on this app.
To be educated, but I'm so frustrated.